लोगों से एक कि क्या मेरे को ज्ञान सच्चा लगता है या अपनी प्रॉब्लम। वी हैव टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द बेस, वी हैव टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द फाउंडेशन। हमारा जो मन है वो फिकर में तभी आता है जब उसको हम कोई चीज सच्ची लगने देते हैं। एनीथिंग दैट फील्स वेरी रियल फॉर द माइंड स्टार्ट्स गोइंग एट इट, इट स्टार्ट्स टू गो फॉर इट, इट यूजेस ऑल इट्स इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, ऑल इट्स इंफॉर्मेशन, ऑल द नॉलेज एंड विजडम दैट ही हैज, ही पुट्स इट ऑल टूगेदर टू सॉल्व अ प्रॉब्लम व्हिच ही थिंक्स इज रियल। So now I am asking you this question. It is also a very strong foundation. You need to understand, am I still finding the world in which my problem exists real, or am I finding the gyan real? Two realities cannot float together. Two kinds of jagat cannot float together. या तो ज्ञान रहेगा या तो संसार की समझ रहेगी, या तो सुजागी और जागृता रहेगी या तो अंधकार और अज्ञान रहेगा. Now if both coexist, your existence will become very messy. मतलब my ignorance runs really deep, that I'm allowing अंधकार, darkness, ignorance to coexist with me. That means I am compromising. That means I'm okay to be abused, I'm okay to be used, I'm okay for my human birth to go down the drain. We are really creating a lot of challenges for ourselves. किसी और को हमको बेचारा करके नहीं देखना है. सबसे बड़ा बेचारा कौन है? स्वयं, जिसका मन अभी भी अंधकार में छुप के बैठा है. वी आर लिटरली ऑन द बेड विद अ स्प्रेडशीट ऑफ डार्कनेस एंड इग्नोरेंस. छुप के बैठा है मन अंधकार में और बहाने मारता है कि अरे रोशनी थोड़ी तेज है ना, मैं वहां पे कैसे जाऊं? अब अंधकार में रहना तो मेरी ड्यूटी है ना. अब अंधकार में तो वी हैव टू नो, वी हैव टू एडजस्ट इन दिस लाइफ. नो, व्हाई डू यू हैव टू एडजस्ट विद डार्कनेस? Why do you have to adjust with ignorance? When I'm using these adjectives, that of darkness and ignorance, what am I referring to? I'm referring to your own tendencies, which are not acceptable by the people around and by yourself. Ek to maine bahut zyada gand paal ke rakha hai, which is being okay with my lower self. What is the meaning? I'm okay to throw tantrums once in a while. I'm okay to get upset once in a while. I'm okay to not being thankful once in a while. I'm okay to feel like I am something once in a while. I'm okay to be confused once in a while. Again, confusion sometimes is healthy, like the confusion of Arjuna. Arjuna ka confusion healthy tha, isliye swayam Narayan Krishna roop mein prakat hokar unko kya sunate hain? Gyan sunate hain. You understand? It is the wisdom which helps us come out of our darkness. What did Krishna do? Did Krishna fight the battle for him and give him everything in a plate? No, that is not the point. So we need to learn from our epics. We need to learn from our own gods and goddesses that we worship. What is the message? The message is bring in the enlightenment inside you. Bring in the wisdom inside you. Do not compromise. Do not run away. Do not do a runaway. Do not contemplate on defending your own weaknesses. It never works. What is okayness? From where does that come? Okayness doesn't mean you become a vegetable, doesn't mean you become a doormat. Nobody can make you a doormat. You become a doormat yourself with the thought that you can become a doormat. Tu to atma hai na, tu to satta hai, tu brahm hai. You are the only god that exists. Nothingness cannot come into experience if you exist. Ya to tu rahega ya to kuch nahi rahega. Sant, dono ek saath nahi ho sakte. To meri baat bahut gehrai se samajhna. brain, which is our mind, and our spiritual mind has the tendency to quickly go and plop itself in an empty spot if you have one. So which is the empty spot that we have normally? Self-pity. I exist. Oh my God, this is one situation and I have a problem. Ye jo usko hum void bolte hain, an empty spot which is normally created and exists due to ignorance, which means hum khud hi is empty spot ko banaye rakhte hain and we do whatever it takes to make sure it does not get filled. And if that is the case, how much ever you and me listen to Gyan, how much ever you are sitting here and I pull you out from that space, from that void, if you continue to have the void in your system, your mind has a normal aptitude, capacity to go and plop itself back again into that spot. So what is it that I have to do? As much of wisdom that I listen to, I have to chew it right in my system. Again, coming back to the question, ki abhi bhi mere ko gyan sachcha lagta hai ki mere ko ye duniya, ye jagat, my problem sachi lagti hai. Please understand, ye sachcha lagna is the poison hidden inside this ocean of atma. Jaise devtaon ne aur daityon ne kya kara, samudra ka manthan kara, to usme se do cheeze nikli, ek hai vish aur dusra hai amrit. Hamare andar bhi atma roopi sagar mein bhi do cheeze hain. Ek hai vish, kis cheez ka, जगत सत लगना वाला भाव ही विष है एंड आत्म का अनुभव इज अमृत. हमारे अंदर भी जब आप मथोगे सेल्फ एनालिसिस में, दो चीजें जो आपको दिखाई देगा, एक है विष, एक है अमृत. कौन सा विष है? माय प्रॉब्लम्स एग्जिस्ट बिकॉज द वर्ल्ड एग्जिस्ट एंड द वर्ल्ड इज द फीलिंग ऑफ द आई दैट एग्जिस्ट. Negativity exists, therefore I have to fight it, and positivity also exists, therefore I need to have that positive aptitude. Oh my God, it's quite crowded out there, and that feeling that all of this is the poison. And what is the Amrit, guys? The Amrit is the experience of your true self, which is ageless, which is sexless, which is timeless, which is beyond any kind of pleasure that you can ever imagine. And not experiencing that, having this human body, is such a shame. You can be a 5-year-old or a 100-year-old person. It doesn't matter. In fact, the younger you are, the faster and deeper would you be able to catch this. Aptitude आपके अंदर है, बहुत अच्छी बात है, उसको हम और शार्प कर सकते हैं. Aptitude नहीं है तो हम वो भी आपके लिए क्रिएट कर सकते हैं आपके अंदर. और अगर आपके अंदर एप्टीट्यूड क्रिएट करने वाली क्षमता भी नहीं है, ट्रस्ट मी गाइज, आई विल क्रिएट दैट एप्टीट्यूड फ्रॉम द आउटसाइड एंड पुट इट इन योर सिस्टम थ्रू द वाइब्रेशंस ऑफ लव एंड ज्ञान एंड ब्लेसिंग्स.